I love Harry Potter.
I've been writing a new song every day and posting it to YouTube for the last 2,000 days. I write about all kinds of stuff, from politics to video games to science to what's going on in my life to, well, sometimes I just write about not knowing what to write about. Occasionally, I write songs about books that I love. In the case of Harry Potter, over the last 6 years, I've written and recorded 5 songs that take place in his world. All of the recording thus far has been done from my home here in Brooklyn, and all that's left to do is record a few more elements. First, there's real drums, for which I'm turning to my friend and the keeper of keys and grounds, Jesse Olson Bay. Next, there's horns, for which I'm turning to my friend, the herbology teacher and horn maestro, Matthew Joseph Payne. Finally, there's mixing and mastering, which will be done by potions teacher Nick Krill of the Spinto Band and Teen Men, and headmaster Jeff Lipton over at Peerless Mastering, the most masterful mastering master in the world. Let's check out the songs. In the song Muggles, imagine if the character that Bruce Willis always plays, the grizzled veteran who's too old for this shit, worked for the Ministry of Magic in the Muggles liaison office.
Right up in the cop car looking official. Two drunk Muggles, they can see a look pissed. So Muggles stagger up.
This song, It Could Have Been Neville, is about this quote that Dumbledore says in Book 5.
Sybil's prophecy could have applied to 2 wizard boys, both born at the end of July that year, both of whom had parents in the Order of the Phoenix. One, of course, was you. The other was Neville Longbottom.
Voldemort, I wanted it to be Neville. It could have been Neville.
Hell yes, it could have been Neville. The song, It Sucks to Be a Squib, is about what it might actually feel like to be a non-magical kid born into a magical family. It would really suck, you know, all your life you're waiting for this thing to happen and it just never does. It's sad.
Oh, how it sucks to be a squib, not magical at all. All the other kids are doing magic in the hall. Would take a bludger to the face, I'd scarily grow my ribs if only I could.
In this next song, I imagine Harry's younger son, Albus Severus Potter, wondering, not for the first time, exactly how his famous father beat the most powerful wizard of all time. And the answer is always the same, love is the most powerful magic. I love this idea because, cheesy as it is, that concept that's at the heart of the books, and I love that. And it also happens to be true. Love is the most powerful magic.
Papa said, Albus, listen to me, he said, it's love, yes it's love. That's what he said. It's love, yes it's love. That's the magic. It's love, yes it's love. Because love is the most powerful.
Finally, there's a song called Lily's Eyes, which is simply a song told from Snape's perspective as he lay dying next to Harry.
On the playground, we lay down and stared at the clouds. Children, but love was built and I saw my future go by in Lily's eyes.
5 songs, I'm super proud of them. I think you're really gonna love them. I just need a little bit of help finishing it up. Here's how it breaks down.
It'll be $1,800 for mixing and $1,500 for mastering. It'll be $1,000 for the drums and $1,300 for the horns. If my math is correct, where's Hermione when you need her? Then finishing this album will cost $5,600 or about 4.5 gold coins.
Okay, I need to take a moment here because perhaps you're thinking to yourself, hey Jonathan, these songs sound pretty good. Why do you need to pay all these people all this money? First of all, hypothetical viewer, thank you very much. I'm really proud of these songs. I've worked really hard on them. The benefits of adding real drums versus the programmed, computerized drums that I've used thus far are, I hope, obvious, as are the benefits of adding horns, a skill which I simply do not possess. And as for mixing, the difference between a well-mixed song and a poorly mixed one is like the difference between making a batch of Felix Felicis that works perfectly and making a batch where one sip will kill you. Mastering is like the dark arts, dangerous, volatile, mysterious, and only the most powerful wizards can even attempt it without descending into the depths of hell. Okay, I hope that clears up your hypothetical question. So that's it. I know you're really gonna love these songs when they're finished, and I hope that you're gonna enjoy listening to them as much as I've enjoyed making them. Please donate what you can, and I'm gonna